You know, most of you, Neha, you also said.
I don't have any doubt.
Oh, you know that? You know 2 power 0 is 1?
Yes, sir, now I understood.
No, 2 power 0 is 1. But can anyone prove me why 2 power 0 is 1? So let's observe. Yashika, everyone, concentrate. So what is 2 square? Yashika, do the mathematics and tell me what is 2 square. 2 square is 2 into 2, right?
Four, sir.
Very good. What is 2 cube? Very good. What is 2 to the power of 4?
16.
Very good. What is 2 to the power of 5?
32.
Very good. That's enough. What is 2 to the power of 1?
2.
No, sir, 2.
You said
2. 2 to the power of 1 is 2, right? Ah.
So I'm just saying, you said Q, right? What is Q?
I asked 2 to the power of 1.
No, before that, I didn't understand what you meant by Q.
Oh, I did not say cube. I said 2 to the power of 3. I said 2 cube. You know, okay, I'm sorry. When we go to higher standard, you don't say 2 to the power of 3. You say it as 2 cube.
Two is to power of 3 is 2 cube and 2 is to the power of 2 is 2 square.
Correct. 2 to the power of 2, we say it as 2 square. 2 to the power of 3, we call it as 2 cube. That is a normal, you know, I also teach to the higher classes, right? So that's a standard cube, square, that's how we say. But I'm sorry, I'm extremely sorry, Yashika. So 2 to the power of 2. This is 2 to the power of 2.
Thank you for telling me, sir.
You want to learn that also? Wonderful. Okay, concentrate now. All of you, observe. Observe now. Everyone. Now, from 32 to 16, when I'm going from 2 to the power of 5 to 2 to the power of 4, can I say the value has become half?
Read the question.
The question is, my question is 2 to the power of 5, when I'm going from 2 to the power of 5 to 2 to the power of 4, can I say the value has become half? 32 has become 16.
Yes, sir.
Can I say it has become half?
Yes,
sir, we can.
Very good. Now, from 16 to 18, can I say it has also become half? Can everyone observe that?
Yeah, but... Yeah.
16 has become half. From 2 power 4, yeah. I'm going to 2 power 3, it has become half. Can you see that?
Yeah.
Now, yes, when I go from 8 to 4, from 2 cube to, so I'm taking every step. Now, from 2 cube to 2 square, if I'm
it
going
is
from...
divided into 2.
So, can you see it is becoming half? Yes, it is divided by 2. Yes, correct. It is becoming half. The value is becoming half.
Just because everything becomes half, 2 into 0 can be 1.
Wait, Yashika, wait. Please stick to the concept. When I'm asking, we'll come there. Now tell me from 4 to 2.
Sir, can I please say something?
Wait. From 4 to 2, can I say once again it has become half? Everyone.
Yes, sir.
Now, if you observe from 2 power 1, if I go to 2 to the power of 0, if you see the trend from 5 to 4 to 3 to 2 to 1, same logic should continue. The value should be.
That's what I wanted to say.
I know better you want to say, but let me explain to the entire class. It's very important. I know you understood. Please wait. I know you want to say, but let's understand, get to the logic. 2 power 0, can I say it's equal to 1 now?
Yes, sir.
Beta, please understand. Aap logon ko samajh aa gaya, matlab you have learned it. You need not tell me that you have, it's understood. You know, if you're already able to see that trend, that's what you're learning. This is how you should observe trends. Okay? This logic holds good for any number. Now let's look at for 3. Let's do it. Tell me what is 3 power 1? What is 3 power 1?
3.
What is 3 square?
9.
What is 3 cube?
27.
Now observe. Now I want to understand. Now let's see. From 27 to 9, what is happening? It is getting divided by 3.
It's dividing by 3, yes, sir.
From here to here, if I'm going from 9 to 3, can I say it's getting divided by 3?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Once again, now from here to here, if I'm going up, what it should be divided by 3 once again. Therefore, 3 divided by 3, answer should be 1.
Sir?
Yes?
Sir, is 1 upon 3 same as 3 because you've put 1 upon 3?
No, I'm not saying 1 upon 3. This 3 is becoming 1 third is what I'm trying to tell you. Is everyone able to follow? Darshil, why are you switching on yourself? I am trying to, yeah.
Actually, I was just like saying that itself, but in the descending order also, like I understood that, but how I looked at it was like this 2 into 4, like it's becoming doubled.
Okay, very good, no problem. Now everyone understood the logic. Now, Yashika, did you understand why 2 to the power of 0 is 1? Okay. So, Yashika, basically this is all about, observing trends. You know, the way you need to understand is 2 power 0 means you're not taking any value of 0, you know, any power of 2. So, basically, 1 is a number, 1 is a factor which comes with any number, not taking, it's a unitary number. That's the reason 2 power 0 is always 1. So please understand few things. So basically,
so
yes,
I'm just trying to say that you would 2 power 1 is 2 multiplied by 1, right?
No, 2 power 1 kind of, yes.
And the same thing goes with all the other numbers, but correct, not 0. But why not 0?
No, we are not multiplying with 0. You know, when we are multiplying with 0, any number will become 0.
Yeah.
So basically, let's assume, what do you mean by 2 power 1? What do you mean by 2 power 1? 2 power 1 is, you know, I'm taking 2 ones. So basically 2 power 1 is 2. So you what you are saying is 2 power 1 is multiplied with 1. What you are saying is 2 square is also multiplied with 1. So whether you multiply or not, this factor 1 will be common to any number for that matter. Right? So now, okay, I'll tell you one more thing, then you'll appreciate it. There is something called 2 power minus 1. Now, 2 power minus 1, when you go to higher standards, you will learn 2 power minus 1 is nothing but 1 by 2, because this 1 actually becomes half once again. So there is another way to prove this. I don't know how many of you will understand that, but I'll try my best to teach that method also. Please concentrate.
So can you explain how I didn't get that minus 1 thing?
No, this is too early for you, beta. That is not required for you. You people are asking something that you don't require now.
But sir, I understand.
Okay, very good. Concentrate, everyone. Now, do you know 2 divided by 2? What do you mean by 2 divided by 2?
Sir,
2 divided by 2 is 1.
Very good. 2 divided by... Very good. Wait. 2 divided by... My question is, what is 2 divided by 2?
0.
No, it's not 0, it's 1. I'm not asking you the remainder. I'm asking you, what is the value when 2 is divided by 2?
1.
2 divided by 2 is 1. So basically, it's nothing but 2 to the power of 1 by 2 to the power of 1. 2 to the power of 1 by 2 to the power of 1. Okay, that's the meaning of 2 divided by 2. So now, tell me, what is 2 to the power of 2 by 2? Can anyone tell me what is 2 to the power of 2 by 2?
The 2.
How did you say that, Bhumika? Very good. But how?
First, I just solved 2 to the power of 2, which is 4, and 4 divided by 2 is 2.
Wonderful. 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 Now, tell me, what is 2 to the power of 3 divided by 2?
3.
4.
No, sir. 4. 4. Sorry, 4.
4. How did 4. You do it?
So 2 into 2 into 2 is 6, and that divided by 2 is 4.
Wonderful. Yashika, you are able to follow all this?
It's not 6, it's 8.
What?
Sir, I think Pragya said 2 into 2 into 2 is 6 times
8. No, sir, she's right. She's right, sir. It's actually 8. It's 8, sir.
Right. 8 divided by 2, can I say it's 4?
Yes, sir.
Now, please observe. Please observe. Please observe. Now, please observe. Yashika, I'm waiting for you to respond to this. 2 to the power of 3 by 2 is 4. Can I write?